suspense. This is the Man in Black, here to introduce Columbia's program, Suspense. Tonight, a study in terror by Lucille Fletcher called Sorry, Wrong of Her. If you've been with us before, you will know that suspense is compounded of mystery and suspicion and dangerous adventure. In this series are tales calculated to intrigue you, to stir your nerves, to offer you a precarious situation, and then withhold the solution until the last possible moment. And so it is with the story, Sorry Wrong Number. We again hope to keep you in suspense.
Some poor innocent woman who was all alone in a house near a bridge, and We've got to stop them. We've got to.
What number were you calling, please?
Well, that doesn't matter. This was a wrong number, and you dialed it for me. We've got to find out what it was immediately.
What number did you call?
Oh, why are you so stupid? What time is it? Do you mean to tell me you can't find out what that number was just now?
I'll connect you with the chief operator.
Oh, I think it's perfectly shameful. Now look, look! It was obviously a case of some little slip of the finger. I told you to try Murray Hill 41133 for me. You dialed it, but your finger must have slipped, and I was connected with some other number. And I couldn't hear them, but they couldn't hear me. Now, I simply fail to see why you couldn't make that same mistake again on purpose. Why you couldn't try to dial Murray Hill 41133 in the same sort of careless way.
Murray Hill 41133?
Yes.
I'll try to get it for you.
Well, thank you.
Albert Smythe Stevenson of 53
Lord Sutton Place. I'm calling up to report a murder. The murder hasn't been committed yet, but I just overheard plans for it over the telephone, over a wrong number that the operator gave me. I've been trying to trace down the call myself, but everyone is so stupid. And I guess in the end, you're the only people who can do anything.
Yes, ma'am.
It was a perfectly definite murder. I heard their plans distinctly. Two men were talking, and they were going to murder some woman at 11:15 tonight. She lived in a house near a bridge. Are you listening to me?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
And there was a private patrolman on the street. He was going to go around for a beer on Second Avenue, and there was some third man, a client, who was paying to have this poor woman murdered. They're going to take her rings and bracelets and use a knife. Well, it's unnerved me dreadfully, and I'm not well, and I feel so...
I see. When was all this, ma'am?
About 8 minutes ago. Then you can do something. You do understand.
What is your name, ma'am?
Mrs. Stevenson. Mrs. Elbert Stevenson.
And your address?
Oh, 53 North Sutton Place. 53 North Sutton Place. That's near a bridge. The Queensborough Bridge, you know, and we have a private patrolman on our street. And second...
And what was the number you were calling?
Murray Hill 41133, but that wasn't the number I overheard. I mean, Murray Hill 41133 is my husband's office. He's working late tonight, and I was trying to reach him to ask him to come home. I'm an invalid, you know, and it's the maid's night off, and I hate to be alone, even though he says I'm perfectly safe as long as I have a telephone right beside my bed.
Well, we'll look into it, Mrs. Stevenson, and see if we can check it out with the telephone company.
But the telephone company said they couldn't check the call if the parties had stopped talking. I've already taken care of that.
Oh, you have?
Yes, and personally, I feel you ought to do something far more immediate and drastic than just check the call. What good does checking the call do if they stop talking? By the time you tracked it down, they'll already have committed the murder.
Well, we'll take care of it. Don't you worry.
I'd say the whole thing calls for a search, a complete and thorough search of the whole city. Now, I'm very near a bridge, and I'm not far from Second Avenue, and I know I'd feel a whole lot better if you sent around a radio car to this neighborhood at once.
And what makes you think the murder's going to be committed in your neighborhood, ma'am? Second Avenue is a very long street, ma'am. And you know how many bridges there are in the city of New York alone?
Yes, I know.
Not to mention Brooklyn, Staten Island, Queens, and the Bronx.
I know that.
How do you know there isn't some little house on Staten Island, some little Second Avenue you never even heard about? How do you know they're even talking about New York at all?
But I heard the call on the New York dialing system.
Maybe it was a long-distance call you overheard.
Oh, no, don't.
Telephones are a funny thing. Look, lady, why don't you look at it this way? Supposing you hadn't broken into the telephone call, right? Supposing you've gotten your husband the way you always do, you wouldn't be so upset, would you?
No, I suppose not. Oh, it sounded so inhuman, so cold-blooded.
A lot of murders are plotted in this city every day, ma'am, and we manage to prevent mostly all of them.
But
a clue of this kind is so vague, it isn't much more use to us than no clue at all. Unless, of course, you have some reason for thinking this call was phony and that someone may be planning to murder you.
Me? No, I hardly think so. Why should anybody? I'm alone all day and night. I see nobody except my maid Eloise, and she's a big girl. She weighs 200 pounds. She's too lazy to bring up my breakfast tray, and the only other person is my husband. Albert. He's crazy about me. He just adores me. He waits on me hand and foot. He's scarcely left my side since I took sick, 12 years ago.
Well, then, there's nothing for you to worry about. Now, if you would just leave the rest of this to us, we'll take care of it.
Oh, you do? It's so late. It's nearly 11 now.
We'll take care of it, lady.
Will you broadcast it all over the city? and we sent out squads and warrior radio cars to watch it, especially in suspicious neighborhoods like mine.
Lady, I said we'll take care of it. Just now I've got a couple of other matters here on my desk that require immediate attention. Good night, ma'am, and thank you.
Oh, you! Idiot!
call, please.
Where were you just now? Why didn't you answer at once? Give me the police department.
I'm sorry, the line is busy. I won't call you.
Busy? But that's impossible. The police department can be busy. There must be other lines available.
The line is busy. I will try to get them for you later.
No, no, I've got to speak to them now or it may be too late. I've got to talk to someone.
What number do you wish to speak to?
I don't know. There must be someone to protect people beside the police department. A detective agency?
You will find agencies listed in the classified directory.
I don't have a classified. I'm too nervous to look it up and I don't know how to use it.
I will connect you with information. Perhaps she will be able to help you.
No! No! Oh, you're being spiteful, aren't you? You don't care, do you, what happens to me? I could die and you wouldn't care.
Who was it you wished to speak to?
I want the nurse's registry at once. I want a trained nurse. nurse. I want to hire her immediately for the night.
I see. And what is the nature of the case, ma'am?
Nurse, I'm very nervous. I need soothing companionship. You see, my husband is away and I...
Have you been recommended to us by any doctor in particular, ma'am?
No, but I really don't see why all this catechizing is necessary. I just want a trained nurse. I was a patient in your hospital 2 years ago, and after all, I do expect to pay this person for attending me.
Well, we quite understand that, ma'am. But these are war times, you know.
Well,
registered nurses are very scarce just now. And our superintendent has asked us to send people out only on cases where the physician in charge feels that it's absolutely necessary.
Well, it is absolutely necessary. I'm a sick woman. I'm very upset. Very. I'm alone in this house, and I'm an invalid, and tonight I overheard a telephone conversation that upset me terribly. In fact, if someone doesn't come at once, I'm afraid I'll go out of my mind!
I see. Well, I'll speak to Miss Phillips as soon as she comes in. And what is your name, ma'am?
Miss Phillips, when do you expect her in?
Well, I really couldn't say. She went out to supper at 11 o'clock.
11 o'clock, but it's not 11 yet. Oh, my clock has stopped. I thought it was running down. What time is it?
Just 11:15.
What was that?
What was what?
That click just now in my own telephone, as though someone had lifted the receiver off the hook of the extension telephone downstairs.
Well, I didn't hear it, ma'am. Now, about this...
But I did! There's someone in this house! Someone downstairs in the kitchen! They're listening to me now! I won't pick it up. I won't let them hear me. I'll be quiet! And they'll think... Oh, but if I don't call someone now, while they're still down there, there'll be no time!
Branch of the Ocean County Library.
And it will be on October 22nd, where you will be doing the classic Dracula. So, mark your calendars, it's a Saturday afternoon, it's free. Come out to Manchester and watch Dracula. Dave!
Okay. And so, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the end of another broadcast. We hope that you have enjoyed your journey to the not so long ago. We return you now to 2016. We'll be back again for our holiday show and our Halloween show in December. Well, switch that. So mark your calendars. Mess me up.
Stick to the script.
I will. And as always, we thank you for your time. This time, until next time, this is WREP signing off.